without coming of Mahdi عليه السلام there will be no unity for Muslims. Must be Khalifa. And the Khalifa must carry the flag of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the flag of Prophet is in Istanbul. In the museum. In top copy. In the Amanat al-Muqaddas for Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. His jubba there. His sword there. His flag is there. When Mahdi عليه السلام comes, wear the jubba, carry the flag, take the sword. At that time, jihad is accepted. Islamic jihad. Or else, there is nothing.
Compulsory. Huh? It's not compulsory.
It's not compulsory now. And when Mahdi عليه السلام comes, it's not with army. He doesn't need weapons. Every country is buying weapons for what? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Between East and West, they are going to hear the takbir of Mahdi alayhi salam. He appears in Madinatul Munawwara. Awliya are expecting the appearance, the permission to be granted, because Mahdi alayhi salam is not an imaginary figure. He's a real figure. And in all books of hadith, mentioning of Mahdi alayhi salam is one of the most, it is one of the belief of Muslims, because it is part of Islam. So if you rejected, or you say, oh, there is still time, or we don't know, means you are denying. Part of Islam means you become an apostate. Because if you deny any part of Islam, as if you have denied Islam. Islam is a complete. الْيَوْمَ أَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ الْيَوْمَ أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today I have perfected and I completed for you my favors and I accepted Islam for you as a religion. It's a complete package. So if you take one out, means you are not following Islam. Where Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah would they say themselves they are the leaders of the Muslims? Why they are not speaking about Mahdi alayhi salam? People think it's only for Shia. That's where they're making the division. Yeah. Shia are not dividing the Ummah, but Ahlul Sunnah wa Jama'ah are dividing the Ummah. Shia are holding and saying, no, we believe in Imam Mahdi alayhi salam. It's part of the religion. Ahlul Sunnah wa Jama'ah has to confirm that also. That yes, it is part of the belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And it is part of our belief. Yeah. If we reject it, we are rejecting Islam.
I think only Wahhabi may be rejected. So the lives will accept them.
They accept, but Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Intisaru al-Faraji ibadah. To wait for what's coming up is worshipness. Who is from Ahlul Sunnah wa Jama'ah you are hearing speaking about Mahdi? Tell me.
They except two people. Yes.
And very few of them. Most of them, they forgot about him. Means Mahdi alayhi salam is, as I said to you, is not waiting, is not, he is waiting for the permission to appear, but he is there with awliya ridwanullah alayhim. He is personally is around us, and awliya meeting with him and seeing him and are, they gave him بيعة. He took his hand. And one time in the 1970s, in the 70s, might be 1971, I was in a seclusion, but not 100% seclusion, is half seclusion. And I was sitting and writing the notes and fixing and making it nicely done of our grand sheikh, Maulana Sheikh Nazim's sheikhs. I was in his time, I knew him very well. And at that time I was always registering, writing his speeches, suhba. He comes, a people comes to his room and he speaks hours and hours and hours and hours non-stop. And what he says now, he doesn't repeat it after. Something new. Like a fountain of water coming, a waterfall. From where is that knowledge? He has not one book in his house. He is illiterate. Not illiterate, there is a better word in English. No. They told it to me in California, say, don't say illiterate anymore. Say, there is a word.
Unlettered.
Yeah. What's that?
Unlettered.
Yeah.
Not reading.
Yeah, not illiterate. Illiterate means
yeah.
Not educated. But unlettered means
yeah.
Doesn't read or doesn't write. His heart always connected to the heart of Prophet. From there he's giving.
Knowledge by present, they call
it. Yeah. Knowledge by present.
Haduri,
now. So, I was not cleaning, so, you know, from rough, what you call it, min al khartush, min al. Yeah, coming and fixing and so on. And then I begin to make zikr. I stopped, I begin to make zikr. At that moment, Grand Sheikh appeared and he said, we are taking you to give bay'ah to Mahdi alayhi salam. And that happened to me in 1971. This is one of the experiences. And
he appeared,
yeah. And he said, close your eyes because you cannot see. If you see, you cannot continue. So I have to keep closing my eyes. And he said, extend your hand. And as I extended my hand, he said, now you are giving, your hand is in my hand. And then he said, now there is 7,007 Naqshbandi sheikhs. You are in the same time giving bay'ah to them. And there is, and now I felt as if 7,007 were putting their hands on my hand. And then he said, 124,000 prophets. Hands and 124,000 hands were over my hand. And he said, now Mahdi is alayhi salam's hand. And I felt Sayyidina al-Mahdi hand, and then he said, now Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they gave that talqin, that bay'ah, and it was a very big experience to me that I, after that, I, for many days, I was not conscious. My mind was
unconscious.
My mind was crazy. In that state of ecstasy or that state, what happened, it made me. And after that, before that, I saw they invited me. Before that happened, that bay'ah, there was an introduction for it, where Mahdi alayhi salam with Sayyidina Isa, with our grand sheikh. Three of them appeared and they took me to a place where they were moving, like in the moving over, like there is a road, but it's not a road, and they were moving without walking, like moving in space.
Flying.
It's not flying. It's as if walking, but you don't see it move, but they move. It's a spiritual moving. And both sides were army of Mahdi alayhi salam, preparing them. They took me and they said the time is very near. And at that time, Grand Sheikh, may Allah sanctify his soul, he said that time of Mahdi alayhi salam is so near, I am giving you your name between the Khulafa of Mahdi alayhi salam. And he gave me one of these 40 names. Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam has 40 Khalifas and 59 deputies, total 99. Everyone under one tajalli of one attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said that that is you, and he gave him, he gave that picture and that name. So Mahdi alayhi salam is not an imaginary figure, and not a figure that is not existing in the present. No, it is. He is existing, waiting only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's permission to appear. When he appears, first he has to islah al-ulama, to fix, you say, islah, to reform the ulama, because ulama first going to deny him.
Yes.
Not Ahlul Kufr going to deny, because they are already Ahlul Kufr. But ulama will oppose him. And there is no, with Mahdi alayhi salam, there is no opposition. He's coming with heavenly power. Allahu Akbar. First, he appeared in Madinatul Munawwara. From Mecca, he is married and he has three children now. Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam. His three children, and he will be appearing from Madinat al-Munawwara, where he say, as he appears, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. And he immediately descend in Madinat al-Munawwara from Magharat al-Su'ada. He is in a heavenly paradise between Yemen and Madinat al-Munawwara in al-Rub' al-Khali. It's a desert. But there is a big cave there. It is a paradise. It's not a cave. Awliya describe it as a paradise, where he is staying with his Khulafa and his deputies and his ministers. And his ministers are Shahamat al-Fardani, Yusuf al-Siddiq, Abdul Rauf al-Yamani, Imam al-Arifin Aman al-Haq, Lisan al-Mutakallimin, Aunullah al-Sakhawi, Arif al-Tayyar al-Ma'ruf al-Han, Burhan al-Qurama'i, Ghawth al-Anam. Seven ministers. 24 hours, they are in his presence, and all of them, with the 40 Khalifa and 59 deputies, in the presence of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That place no one can reach is secured by seven different groups. Budala, Nujaba, Nukaba, Autad, Akhyar, Jinn and Malaik. That is securing that area.
Between Medina
and Yemen, it is in Rub'ul Khari, it's a desert that no one can trespass there. And any trespassing, it will change immediately into stone. And in the time of the French, when they were invading the desert, many of their troops were turned into stone. They disappeared in the desert. Now, according to the new technology and the satellites, NASA released some pictures of the Rub' al-Khali where it shows human stones on the shape of human beings, which confirm what Awliya has described and what they have said. When he from there, in one moment, he will be in Madinat al-Munawwara. By Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, he is there. Khatwa. Bittay. Haqiqat al-Tay. The reality of moving in space. And how they move in space? Now your spirit is in the cage of the body. It's caged. It's in prison. You cannot make your spirit to move out. So with the physical body, that body is attached to earth. So it is pulled by gravity of the earth, because it relates to earth. When your spirit become more stronger than the body, then the spirit is attached to heaven. It will pull you up toward heaven. And where is up? Is in every direction. There is no up, there is no down. Everything is up, everything is down. That's why we say, فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. Wherever you direct your face, Allah, you find your Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. So the gravity means the worldly desirely pleasure is pulling you down toward the gravity of the earth. When you release yourself from that, then your body will be light by the power of the spirit. That's what even science confirmed that by when they send the astronauts to the outer space, there is no gravity. Astronauts are floating in the air because there is no gravity of the earth affecting them in their outer space. Also, there is an outer space for spiritual power that will take your body, will be floating in that system. So when that is the case, means you can move with the speed of light, because your spirit is energy and from Bahr al-Qudra. So when that energy is moving from Bahr al-Qudra, If we want to limit it, we say it's the speed of light. It's far more faster than speed of light. It is more faster even from a thought. Thought is more faster than speed of light, your thought. The movement of angels faster than movement of thought. You will be able to move in the speed of angels' movement when you release your spirit from the gravity of the body. So now you can carry your body. So awliya, to move fi halatul tay, they take out their souls, they put their bodies inside the soul, and they move with the speed of angelic power. And when they appear in the place designated, they take out their body and out, and they put their soul in their body. This is how Haqiqatul Sai works between awliya, and this is the lowest explanation for Haqiqatul Sai. There is higher explanation for it. So when Mahdi alayhi salam comes, he comes in that style of movement, appear in Madinatul Munawwara, calling لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Every mu'min and Muslim and not Muslim are going to hear. There will be who accept, there will be who deny. And then from there, by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, he will be in Damascus, Sham. There is the beginning of everything. And that's why it is not the appearance more and more people are beginning to be interested in Sham al-Sharif. Awliya around the world, they at their last age, they move to Sham to be buried there. It is said that in Sham, most of Anbiya, grave of Anbiya has been moved there by angels. And anybody who pass away from Sham by angels, he will be moved to Sham. Because it is Ardul Mahshar. It is the place of resurrection. Most of Ahlul Bayt are buried in Sham. And it is not out of coincidence that Sayyida Zainab Maqam has been rebuilt in Sham, where it has thousands and thousands of pilgrimage are coming and visiting every day. Yeah, and Ruqayya there, and most of Ahlul Bayt are being buried there. This is to show the symbol of كل أسألكم عليه أجرا إلا المودة في القربة. I'm not asking from you reward or anything, أجر on what I have delivered to you, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, إلا المودة في القربة. Only I am asking to respect and take care of my family. And that symbolizes the presence of Ahlul Bayt in Sham, because Mahdi alayhi salam will be coming to Sham. And that's why Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam didn't enter Sham. He left it for his grandson that's coming at the last. Because if Prophet entered, then no need for Mahdi alayhi salam to enter. So he didn't. He stopped in a place where it is called now Al-Qadam. It's very well known. It's a district of outside Damascus, outside Sham. For Mahdi alayhi salam, as soon as Mahdi alayhi salam appeared, he put fit there. It's a very known place in Damascus. So when he comes there, he says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Any war around the world, any weapon will stop. That secret will be taken out. That secret of technology that is working through energy, it will be stopped, confiscated in the head of Mahdi alayhi salam. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Everyone has a seed or grain of Iman in his heart. By Tay, which we explained before, he will be present in Sham. In one night, Mahdi alayhi salam ordered jinn to build a new city from beginning to end to accommodate the Muslim ummah that will be gathering in Sham al-Sharif. Third takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Every mu'min will be in his hand a sword, a spiritual sword. A sword that when you say Allahu Akbar, with that sword, even you move it like that, whoever kafir on that right side will be gone. Whoever in left will be gone. And he will declare jihad against Masih al-Dajjal. Who in that time, Masih al-Dajjal will be turning around world to create confusion. Mahdi alayhi salam put his army, put his weapons, and at that time prepare everything. At that time, he moved to Istanbul to bring the amanat of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with 12,000 soldiers and 12,000 on the shape of Sayyidina Ali. All there are grandchildren of Sayyidina Ali. Same face, same sword. So Zulfiqar, carrying. And on top of them is Sayyidina Ali. Grand Sheikh said that Sayyidina Ali is not dead yet. Sayyidina Ali is appearing with Mahdi alayhi salam. He was sent many times by Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Usually Sayyidina Fatima al-Zahra used to come to Prophet and say, Ya Rasulullah, I am not complaining. But sometime my husband, Sayyidina Ali, karramallahu wajha, doesn't come home at night. I'm not complaining, but I have to say it. He said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Fatima, I'm sending him. Places where no ins or no jinn can reach. And I'm sending him to outer space creation. If not for Sayyidina Ali's power, these aliens would have invaded the earth long time ago. I'm sending him there. He will appear with Mahdi with 12,000 of his children in the same shape. Because when Sayyidina Ali died, he said, put me on a camel and leave the camel fi mashi'atillah. And they put him on the camel, the Sahaba, and they led the camel as he asked in his will. And the camel went into the hill and disappeared. And after Sahaba were crying, wanted to know where Sayyidina Ali was. And after 1 hour, 2 hours waiting, they found a kafila, caravan coming from the opposite side. They asked them, did you see a camel? They said, we saw a camel, but we saw Sayyidina Ali. And he was greeting us and we were greeting him. And he continued his work. So Awliya expecting Sayyidina Ali with Mahdi alayhi salam. And when Mahdi alayhi salam bring Amanatul Muqaddasa from Istanbul with Sayyidina Ali and the 12,000 of his grandchildren, come back to Masjid al-Amawi, where Sayyidina Isa will be descending. And he will not accept to be the Imam because he is Nabi. He asked Sayyidina al-Mahdi to be the Imam because he said, I asked Allah to give me life to be one of the Ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad. So I'm not leading, you lead. And Imam Mahdi will lead the prayer. And now here is another secret that awliya release sometimes, is that at that time Mahdi alayhi salam will call upon Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is hayyun tariyun fi qabrihi, is fresh alive. He call upon him and Prophet appear by physically. Because it's the last days. It's barzakh and dunya same. Yeah. Hayatul barzakh wa hayatul dunya wiyya at that time is mixing with each other. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam appear. And depending on the level of the people who are living at that time will be present, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will give them his hand. And they will kiss the hand of Prophet. Some people, according to their level, they kiss one time, some two times, some three times, up to 12,000 times. Every time you kiss, a whole knowledge will be driven into your heart, poured into your heart, from the heart of Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Knowledge will be spreading from one to another by eyes reflection. Those who were lucky and kissed the hand of Prophet ﷺ will pass the knowledge to those who did not through eyes. And religion will be covering the whole earth, and Sayyidina Isa will kill Masih al-Dajjal as soon as he approached the fences of Sham al-Sharif. Cannot enter the Sham. He, three places he cannot enter: Makkah, Medina, and Sham. May Allah give us long life to be and to see these things. Awliya Allah are waiting for that happening, for that event. And as I said, رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَعَاهَدُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. They knew that is, this is the reality. They waited. They passed away. The others are waiting to be in that time. If they pass away, they will be brought back. Because they waited. They asked for it. Allah is Kareem from His generosity. If you ask, ادعوني استجب لكم. And if I'm asking Allah, I'm saying, Ya Rabbi, let me be from Mahdi alayhi salam's supporters. And I go. I pass away. You think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His generosity will not send you in the time of Mahdi alayhi salam? Why not? What's the problem? What's the difficulty? There is no difficulty. Kun fayakun. Anyone he is want anyone that was waiting for Mahdi alayhi salam will be brought, because it will be the golden age for this whole universe, because it's the end. Those will be brought to see that time. For those who were waiting for it and they didn't have a chance, Allah will send them. And it's not like a movie you see on the television, but you feel it. You see, those who passed away, they feel, they see, they are existing in that time as if a normal person. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that and grant us that. And inshallah, we'll be in that time. بحرمه الحبيب بحرمه الفاتحه. Yes.
Can I have one question?
You want to be in that time?
I just want to ask, what is the position of Ayatollah Khomeini in this change, Maulana?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala planned everything. He had a role to do and he did his role.
As imam or
some people say this, some people say that. We don't say this, we don't say that. We know he is an instrument, a subject of his Lord. He did what he has to do. He did politic or not politic. Whatever he did, he did. Allah knows best. Because I don't want to say this or say that. I want to leave it general.